so HTML and CSS news is a bunch of news that happened between February and like now. So the biggest release, biggest thing that happened in March is that Firefox 66 was released. So brings a lot of very nice features. First of all, scroll anchoring has been implemented. So that's related to the CSS scroll snap specification. If you don't know what is the CSS scroll snap specification, that's why you must go and read the specification. Google is your friend, yo. The third point, very interesting. Logical property shorthands have landed. So logical properties means that in the beginning, you could only like top, bottom, left, right, like physical dimensions. But if you're using a non-Western language that is, for example, maybe Arabic, which is right to left, or traditional Chinese, which is like right to left, top to bottom, then these physical dimensions don't really make sense when you try to do like margins or paddings. So the working group came up with logical properties. So instead of up, down, left, right, you are using block start, block end, inline start and inline end, which makes it like writing mode agnostic, which is very good. It's like an internationalization effort. A few other good things. I think the star of the show this month is grid template columns and grid template rows are now animatable. So in case you have never used grid before, it's like this. It's a layout system that is native to CSS that is much better than we ever had before. So it came out 2017, so it's about like 2 years old. And in the specification, it was always written that your rows and columns can animate. But until now, like 2 years later, so when something gets written in the specs, right, it just means that it will come in the future. It doesn't mean it will come now. Now, how long in the future, right? No guarantee. So it's like a lawyer like that. Lawyer don't want to guarantee anything. Same pattern. So clearly this nice feature was only implemented in Firefox 66. Other browsers have yet to catch up, so we'll see when it comes in. But it's actually quite fun. Later got an example can show. Min content and max content are keywords that you can use as width and height values. For now, it's very commonly used in the CSS grid template rows and columns. But by rights, according to the spec, you should be able to use it as a standard width keyword. So for example, you want to do, if you have a piece of content that maybe is dynamically pulled in from API or whatever, and you don't know how long it is, right? And you want it to always take up one line. It could be like maybe some keywords thing or something, right? Or somebody's name. So you try to estimate like, oh, okay, maybe like for myself, my name, right, Chen Hui Jing, right, then okay, maybe like 10 m. Then suddenly you get like, I have a friend who's called like Matthew Prentice Potter, God knows what, like 5 words that type, wow, then it will break your whole design. So you can use min content or max content. These are content-based keywords, which are good for these type of scenarios, and now it's available unprefixed. So if you are on Firefox 66, a lot of nice new features. Firefox 66, the sound of silence is like a feature article about all these new features is released on Mozilla Hacks, so you can go and check that out. Another browser that got released is Chrome 73. What's interesting in Chrome 73 is constructible style sheets. This is more of a JavaScript kind of thing, so I'm not going to talk about a lot about it, but you can go and read the release post. It's actually pretty interesting. Now also the link element supports image source set and image sizes. So this is part of the picture element, HTML element, which is good for responsive images. So something good to find out about. This whole dark mode thing came out about, I think, late last year when Mac started doing the light dark mode nonsense. So your media query here is prefers color scheme. So better support for this now. Should be quite interesting if you want your website to match the users. Color scheme preferences, which is great. So if a new version of Chrome come out, DevTools also got new stuff. So Chrome DevTools 74 has a couple of interesting new features. Highlights all nodes affected by CSS property. Kind of nice. I'm biased. I like Firefox better, but Chrome is not bad also for CSS, I suppose. It's also possible to capture area screenshot. This is quite useful. Firefox has been able to do this for a very long time. No, I'm not bashing Chrome. Chrome is very good. Use both, okay? No, inclusive. Okay, now we finally move on to specs. News, a bit quieter this month compared to last month. Color module level 4 was updated. So the color module, basically, what it does is it describes CSS properties that allow us to, you know, describe specify colors. That's fine, everybody knows this. So in level 4, it defines like some new stuff. One of which is color fonts, which is quite interesting. If you use Firefox and visit the Singapore CSS website, you'll notice that our header uses a color font. So yes, we are cutting edge, yo. Another thing is CSS scroll step module level 1. If you were here last month and you paid attention, and I know you didn't, you will realize that I also covered this last month because they made another update this month. I think it was more minor, so it's here again. So there are a lot of interesting articles for the month also. So it's all here. I added a new section which is cool CSS projects, because there is we have an honorary mention. She's called Olivia Ng, currently no longer in Singapore at the moment temporarily, but she always do a lot of very cool code pen things. We are scheming to have her in next month via the magic of technology. We'll keep you updated, but just to give you a taste of the kind of magic that Olivia does in her spare time, this is built with CSS Grid. One of many of her amazing projects. Yes, this is CSS, yo. Anyway, so that's that. That's it for thank you for sitting through the March 2019 edition of HTML and CSS. So now I would like to welcome my first speaker, Hui Qian, who is going to talk about responsive tables.